For today's ProSelect quick tip video, I want to talk about the select size view. Well, as you can see, we've got a job open in ProSelect, and I'm currently in my thumbnail view. What I want to do is we're going to go ahead and I'm going to select an image and just double click that image to bring it up to a full screen in our show image view. From there, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and click our select size view icon. That's the ruler over on our tools on the right here. So we're going to go ahead and click that, and that now puts the image into our select size view. Well, what we can do is by using the up and down arrow keys, that's how we can go through and show the different sizes. But you'll notice here what's going to happen here is I go through these different sizes. Notice how I'm going from square to rectangular to 1:2 format, that it's actually changing the format. You may be doing a major change on the crop with the image each time I do this. Well, I don't always want ProSelect to do that. I want to actually have it set up so that if I'm working in rectangular type crops, it'll move from a 1620 to a 2024, 2430, 2736, 3040, stay in all my standard crops. If I'm working with square images, I want it to move from a 2020 to a 2424 to a 3030. Well, as you can see right now, what's happening, it's not doing that. The format is actually changing on the crops. Well, that's an easy fix. All that we need to do is we want to go up, we're going to go to our orders, and we're going to click on print paper sizes. As you can see, what I've got is I have all of my sizes arranged in order here. I've selected my sizes here. I have them selected. You can see I've got my rectangular sizes 4x5, 4x6, 5x7. You can see 16, 20, 2024, all arranged right in order. I can drop and drag these sizes all to different positions. I can move them around to be able to arrange them exactly the way that I want them. After I've got all of my rectangular sizes, I have my square sizes 5x5, 8x8, 10x10, 12x12, all the way up through my 30x30. Then the next series I have here is my 1:2 ratio, my panoramic type sizes, 10x20, 12x24, 15x30. So again, I put all these and arrange these right in order in this particular dialog box. Now, to make sure that I stay right within the zone where I'm actually working here, I'm going to deselect this button here that says display sorted by paper size. I'm going to go ahead and click close. Let's go back to our show image view. That'll reset it. Now what we'll do is go back and click our select size view here. Now you can see I've got my 4060, 4050, 36x50, 30x45, 30x40. All of my standard ratios are staying right together. Everything that I have selected, they're going right into that particular group. If I want to move quickly to another size ratio group, all I have to do is go to my plus and minus icons here. I'm going to right click or do a control click on my Mac, and I can take and I can see all of my available sizes. We'll go right here to an 8x8. Then from there, I can just use the up and down arrows on my keyboard to be able to go through the different sizes. That's our ProSelect quick tip for today. I'm Ron Nichols.